Whitehall, and the new cost-cutting team of crack civil servants arrived to meet the minister.
Please, are you top up, please, love?
No, I can't stop. I've just got to take a dump. You know how it is.
How many ministers are there, actually? Oh, yes, what's this one? Agriculture, that's a very good one, that, isn't it? That's a marvellous one.
Defence,
yes. Well, that's one. One.
It's two, actually, sir.
Oh.
Yes, a minute.
Oh, they want to know how many ministries we've got. I mean, I don't even know what ministry we are. Excuse me, do you know what ministry we are? Do you know?
Yes.
Now, these are the ministries that we know we've got.
Yes.
And these are the ones we're not too sure of.
It's a start, isn't it? We found some more ministries.
I'm the Minister of Takeaways.
Yeah, it's all right.
Oh, thank you.
Well, I say,
there's a ministry of paper clips.
Well, better add that to the list, then. Hmm?
Down in the basement corridors of Whitehall.
What do you think?
Well, they haven't put us down on the list. I think it's a cheek.
I mean, Ministry of MP's Affairs doesn't sound very good, does it?
The memos continue to circulate.
What about this lipstick, madam? Midnight Blue.
We've run out of pens, you see. We've done so many memos.
We also have another one here, which is called, very nicely, Memo Red.
Oh, yes, that looks just like it. That's fine. Yeah, I use Minister's underpants. I've taken the skid marks out, like.
Stocktaking revealed vast quantities of surplus ministerial bed linen.
Barney, I wouldn't buy a set of sheets that Kenneth Clark slept in. Oh, tea break.
They found all these ministries they didn't know they had. Quite incredible amounts of stuff they didn't know they'd got. Aircraft carriers, 50 pairs of ladies' tights, an interface lead for a Nintendo, Super Mario, Game Boy. They even found a Minister of Agriculture they didn't know they'd got. It was absolutely ridiculous, you know. So silly. And they found 5,000 ladies' hats in the back bedroom at Checkers.
Watch where you're going, you silly tart.
Phone Oxfam, they'll take them. No, better still, the Queen Mother will have them. Quid each.
Navy? Navy? Huh, they're all Navy.
Perhaps we should send them all to the Navy because of the Navy.
Oh, don't talk such utter bollocks.
So they sent the coats to the Navy.
Doreen, any chance of some service? I say, you with the bumps under your jumper. Any chance of some service?
All right, Reverend, coming.
Just ignore him. Three times on Sundays.
They're selling off ladies' coats, you know.
Did you find one your size?
No.
Nor did I.
No, I didn't get anything.
No, I did. I bought a big pair of men's pants.
Did they have skid marks?
What did you get, old boy?
I bought this coat, and it had this old woman inside it.
Ah, bargain.
It's absolutely splendid. Mm-hmm. Thanks, Julie.
Lovely to see Julie Walters getting some character parts these days, eh, Minister? Now, Minister, the import of our conversation, I believe you had a submarine disappear.
Yes.
Five years ago, wasn't it?
A submarine disappeared.
Yes.
Gone. Into the white blue yonder. Just gone away.
On the stocktaking?
Bye-bye. Yes.
Naval stocktaking had revealed a missing submarine. Supreme Allied Command was alerted.
Now, our information is that the submarine is probably in the sea somewhere, so we're going to send out the Navy across here to this scribbly box effort that looks like it's drawn by a child.
The Navy set sail at once. I don't know what you've drawn here, Neville. I'm no good at pictionary.
It's obvious, isn't it? Hello, there's the feet, and there's his, what's name, you know, his,
Blimey, better put some trousers on. The missing submarine was the infamous HMS Seaview.
I don't know why Superstore Port Bow, sir.
Number one, ask the builders what they want, would you? Thank you very much.
As our builders need three bags ready mix, six lengths, 4x2, bathroom vanity unit flat pack, 6-pound bag of Phillips 916 self-tapper, sir. Attention!
Oh, hello, number one.
Thank you, Kevin. I've made a mention to attention, sir, and here's the paper, the relevant paper for you, sir.
Oh, thank you, number one.
Right, stand at ease. A minute now, please, sir.
Thank you, number one. To bring you up to date, everyone, we've knocked through into the engine room to make the new breakfast bar. The plasterers are in there now, putting the air tanks up. Sorry it's taken 5 years. It'll look really nice when it's finished. The gym behind me is fully operational. Oh, if anyone wants to go on the periscope, just let me know. I'd be only too pleased to sell you the tokens.
Go on, Mario, my son. Yep. 450,000, not bad, my son. Go on, you bop.
Over the years at sea, the crew of HMS Seaview had lovingly converted the submarine to include every recreational facility.
Dick, you fancy game of snooker? Not you, Jim. Dick!
No, thanks, bud. I've got a five-side match in a torpedo room.
Meanwhile, in the swamps of the Mississippi...
I've had enough of this. It's ruining my hush puppies.
You shut up about those goddamn shoes. It's only another 5 miles.
Mm. 2 pairs say I get to keep my trousers on.
You're still playing?
Oh, yes.
Your trousers will be on the table before the night's out.
That's what you said last time, and look, we ended up with no kid at all.
I'd rather not talk about that, so...
No, I don't blame you either. No. Right, I will take off my,
A message from the builder, sir.
No peeping right there, mother. Here we go. Finished breakfast bar, started work on dance floor. Right. Better go check this out, then.
I'll come with you.
Anything to get out of the game, eh?
Chicken.
Yes.
Thanks, Tiger.
Well, we'll keep it warm for you.
Just you and me, then.
Oh, no wonder he didn't want us to beep. He'd have lost a lot.
I worked in HMS Seaview, spent 4 years, new roof, loft extension, window boxes, kitchen, bathroom, things like that.
I'm putting a set of patio doors, me.
Hey, what's the point of having patio doors in the submarine?
Didn't they leak?
Well, of course they leaked. They kept opening them. They're stupid.
As the building work on HMS Seaview at last drew to a close, arrangements for the sub-warming party began.
And that was I've Got You by the Trogs. And hi there, Poppikers. Party request to be in by 1500 hours.
Hello, can I buy our silver lining, please?
We ain't got it.
Hello, well, you must have. It's my favourite. Hi, ho, silver lining.
2, 3, 4.
The Navy's search for the missing sub was rather leisurely. Whereas back at Whitehall, there was a new sense of urgency.
There's another sense of urgency over here. The new minister didn't make it to the toilet.
Take a memo, a lost submarine, a long black tubular thing, goes underwater, got that? No need to call back, I'm just sitting across the desk from you.
Allied Command responded at once.
Well, we've taken a slightly different tack here. The Navy's not going to like it. We've got some bounty hunters.
Bounty hunters?
Bounty hunters. So they've got the expertise and the know-how, generally.
You wanted to see us, mister?
Yes, I'm the Royal Navy's cowboy liaison officer, and we want you to look for a submarine.
Submarine?
That's right.
Fine and dandy, fancy pants. We haven't discussed the deal. What's the fee? Any penalty?
Watch a submarine!
Why don't you shut up? Even the Indian knows what a submarine is. It's one of those fat, furry little things with long, knobbly bits hanging down under its tummy.
Ignore him. We'll find you a submarine. It'll cost you $5,000.
Hey, when do you...
Shut up.
Good luck. You can't miss it. It's got a loft extension and a set of patio doors.
Well, there were problems, big problems. A lot of people said, look, back off. It's a bit of a sweat, this one. We've never used the cowboys before to find a submarine. There were cultural difficulties, ethnic difficulties, and a lot of spitting.
We don't need go looking for submarines for that kind of money. We can get plenty of work right here. In the gas station, in the bars, in the deli. Any kind of work
we want. Submarine? The trouble with employing cowboys is they get too emotional. One minute they're up there, then they're down, then they're up again. You can't rely on them.
You've worked with cowboys?
Of course. My mate here was a cowboy. Came along, parked his horse over there. I taught him how to build patio doors. He got quite good at it after a while. I was pleased with him.
Ah, you
did,
that.
He was a cowboy, still got the walk.
I have. Ride him.